My name is Julia. I'm an international student from Peru, and I'm now pursuing my master's in petroleum engineering. In my country, I work for Petro Peru, the national petroleum company, and thanks to Fulbright scholarships, I came here to get trained in cutting-edge and sustainable techniques for the enhanced oil recovery. And in this lab, we'll study the phase behavior of oil mixtures with gases. Enhanced oil recovery with injection of CO2 is a complex technique, and it could get more complicated if the oil has asphaltenes in it. That is actually my research. This equipment, the solid detection system, we can inject CO2 and we can inject oil, and we can see the particles of asphaltenes come out when we change pressure, temperature, and volume. This is actually very cool if we are under 5,000 feet underground, exactly like on the bottom hole of the oil reservoirs, and we can see how the phase behavior change and how the thermodynamics will affect the asphaltene deposition. All these machines help us to understand how the oils work with the mixtures of gases under different pressure, temperature, and volume conditions.
Welcome to the PVT lab. Today I'm gonna show you how we use this high-pressure PVT cell for our research and some examples. We call it a high-pressure PVT cell because it can hold a high pressure up to 70 megapascal. The volume of the cell can be changed, and we can also regulate the temperature in the cell by using this external bath. This cell has a sapphire window, so we can see through this window by using the camera to see the inside of the cell. A typical procedure to use this cell is first we do the cleaning and vacuum. Then we inject some fluids, such as gas, water, oil, or some other solutions into the cell. Then we change the pressure temperature to do the measurements. I have been using this cell for my phase behavior of gas hydrate research. Gas hydrate, we know, is abundant energy in the underground. Hydrates can also be used for desalination, gas storage, transport, separation. Hydrate formation in the pipelines, however, may cause flow assurance problems. By using this cell, I have, for example, measured the phase boundary of gas hydrates at high pressure conditions, and also observed the hydrate growth behavior at the water-gas interface. We also have done some experiments using for the oil gas system. Here are some images. You can see the phase change of oil CO2 system at different pressure conditions. We also have measured some quantities such as bubble point, dew point, swelling factors. We can do much more in this lab. We also have a solid detection system to quantify the solid particles in the solutions. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. We also welcome you to join our lab to start your research.